Then, I'm sorry to say, you will fail to serve the society. Okay? So, what is value education? Inculcating in the children a sense of humanism. Humanism means insaniyat. Jab hum kisi cheez ko dekhte hain, when we see that something wrong is happening, we should take action, okay? We should say for it. A deep concern for the well-being of others and the nation. We should not be selfish enough to only think about ourselves. We should think for the society and also for the loved ones and the family. So what is the first value that we are going to learn? The first value is initiative. Okay? What is it? Initiative. Now, you see in the picture that all are standing in the line, but there is only one person who has stepped forward. You tell me, what is initiative? The ability to take decision or to take the right action or opinion in front of others. Jab hamein koi bhi nahi, okay? You know many times what happens? We have to motivate. The teachers have to motivate. You participate in the class. Why are you not doing? Okay? And you have to tell them again and again. Even a family. Ki aapko ye karna chahiye. Aapko mama ki help karni chahiye. So, agar hum ye nahi bole. And aap apne aap hi ye initiative le. That I should help my mom. I should participate in events. And I should say, when I feel that something wrong is happening, then that is known as initiative. Okay? So it is very important in life that we take initiative. The ability to solve problems and take action by thinking of the solution rather than being told or ordered what to do. Now, as you are growing up, I know you are developing the sense of maturity. You are developing the sense of what is right and what is wrong. Isn't it? हमें धीरे-धीरे समझ में आने लगता है कि this is right and this is wrong. So, when you get this ability and when you are in a difficult situation, you will be able to solve it no matter what. You should think. You should take action, you should speak for yourself and even for others. Okay? I'll give some example. As you can see in this picture, what can we see? There is a mother and there are children who are helping the mother to do the household work. So in many families and in many times you hear that boys do not work. Okay? Boys kitchen ka kaam nahi karte. Boys to sir khel dein. Is that what you think? No, my dear students. We should always help our parents. Because they are doing so much for you. Isn't it? Koi bhi kaam chota ya bada nahi hota hai. And any profession or any work does not have any gender. Cleaning the house, cooking, working. Okay, all this does not mean that it is the only work to be done by the women or the girls in the house. Even the men, the boys should also help your mom and together we should support each other. Always. Okay, this is initiative. You can't cross the sea merely by standing and staring at the water. By Rabindranath Tagore. This is a beautiful quote. Did you understand what it means? If I look at the river, okay, and I feel I can't swim, okay, so how will I cross it? So only by looking. You'll start with one person, but you can motivate so many. Isn't it? So this is initiative, and we should always take initiatives in our lives. Okay, so I'll show you a story about seven women who started a small business and it grew into a large business. Okay, they were not educated, they did not have any degrees, but they had faith in themselves and they took initiative. Let's see.
Long time ago, in 1959, seven women in a village in Bombay decided to do something on their own. They wanted to be independent. They had not gone to colleges and university. They had not learned what you are learning today at school. They were skilled at only one thing, cooking. They decided that they would use the skill to earn their livelihood. They borrowed 80 rupees from a social worker who had later became their guide and mentor. On March 1959, they gathered on terrace of one of their houses. They had already got hold of all the necessary ingredients. Can you guess what they were planning to make? They were going to make papad. Within 3 months, about 25 women had started working at this project. By the third year, about 300 women were making papad. In the first year, the money earned by the women was about 6,000 rupees. Today, the Sri Mahila Udyog Lichat Papad is a cooperative that not only manufactures papad but also other things like flour, bakery products and so on. It is involved in import and export and is a source of inspiration to many. The papad is popularly called Lichat Papad and their logo is
rabbits. Okay, so isn't it inspiring? These seven women, they were not educated, but still they managed to run a business, and today we all enjoy the delicious papad. Okay, so there are many such stories in the world where people started from the bottom. They had no money, but they had faith in themselves and they brought change in the society. So just like them, we can also bring change in the society if we take the initiative. Okay? So I'll quickly ask some questions. Okay, why did the seven women think of making papad? Why did they not? We all know they were scared. They had knowledge, they had understanding, and they wanted to do something independently. So they decided to make papad. What does the cooperative manufacture today? They manufacture many things. Not only papad, but also some masalas. Okay? So I want you all to read the story from the textbook. I'll share the notes with you or the question answers. But my dear students, if you have any problems in life, you share it with me, you can call me, you can message me. Okay? And I'll be there to help you and guide you. So this was your first class of Value Education. I hope you liked it.